I have two green balls and three purple balls. So how many balls do I have altogether? Well, that's going to be two green balls plus three purple balls is going to be five balls altogether. And you see that right over there. There's five balls altogether. We can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, what if we did something a little different? Let's start with the five balls. So we're going to start with the five balls, and you can count them again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now let's take away two. Let's subtract two of these balls. So let's take away one and two. Well, then what are we left with? Well, then we are left with 1, 2, 3 balls. We're left with three balls. And you might already see a pattern here. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. But if you start with 5 and you take away 2, you're going to be left with 3. Look at how this is arranged and look at how this is arranged. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. But 5 minus 2 is 3. 5 minus 2 is 3. And it works the other way around. If I start with 5, and if I were to take away 3, so if I subtract 1, 2, 3, what am I left with? Well, I'm left with 1, 2. I am left with 2. So 2 plus 3 is 5. 3 plus 2 is 5. We see that there, which is another way of saying that 5 minus 2 is 3, or 5 minus 3 is 2. Take a look at this for a little bit. This is a really, really important a pattern or a really important idea to understand in math. If you add two numbers and you get, say, if you add, say, a 2 and a 3, or you add two numbers and you get another number, well, if you take that number and you subtract one of these, you're going to get the other number.